chin.
Anyway, what do you think of all this?
Oh, it's fantastic. They must have had a lot of help.
Absolutely none. They did it all themselves. Myra and Judy were the driving forces.
Oh, that figures. They're remarkable, those two. Let's go say hello.
Nice plants. Did you go home yourself?
Yeah, we did.
Got anything that smells real good? I like to sniff. Flowers, you know?
Yeah, well, take a look at this one. We're pretty attached to it.
Yeah. I like this one.
Good roots, too.
It's great. Just what I need. I'll come back later, okay?
We'll keep it for you.
Yeah, well, when Anne phoned, I contacted Alan. He said you'd rung him.
Yeah.
Not that he's had any luck either. I mean, after all, where do you start looking?
I don't know, Walt. Kay's out there somewhere and I haven't got a clue where to find her.
Yeah, well, how about this fate, huh? It's just taking the edge off things. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I reckon you've done a fantastic job. Oh. Better job than I did teaching. I mean, what is that after all,
eh? Who knows, huh?
But there's some good things here. Look at this.
Oh, yeah, that's one of Cass's. She's very good, you know.
Oh, I think I'd buy that as a memento.
Great. $2.
Hey, thank you. Mr. Walsh, what happened to your beard?
I'll catch up to you later. Listen, Myra, if there's anything I can do to help
yeah,
about Kay, you know.
Thanks, Walter. I'm the only one that can help you now.
You're right. I think I'll get Cass to autograph this.
Come on, Myra, it's not too late to change your mind. Wally said he'd help out.
I'm getting out now, Jude. As fast as I damn well can.
Then you just take the plant inside as if it hasn't been picked up, and you're keeping it for yourself.
Well, then what?
We start taking orders, Pinhead.
And we just leave the dope in the pot plant.
You think of a better place?
Good one, Rib. Listen, don't forget my free snort.
If I did, you'd remind me. Hello, she's making her move. She's not going to get very far.
I don't get it, Rib. Look, if Myra's trying to make a break for it, why don't you just let her go? Then we'll have no one to stuff up our rackets.
You don't get it, do you? Nobody crosses me and gets away with it. She wants out so bad, I'll make bloody sure she stays here.
You're going to do her over?
I'll dirty my hands on her. The screws know where she is. Better still, the frick.
Good one, Rip. How long are you going to be?
As long as it takes. You keep an eye on things.
It's all so exciting. You really saw all that in my hand, crossing the water and all.
Oh, yes, you're definitely going overseas. And soon, too. Of course, I can't tell you the name of the country. It could be England or America or even Tasmania.
And the handsome stranger?
Oh, yes, he's definitely around here somewhere. Here, let me fix your dress so you look pretty for him. My, what a pretty colour. I do like nylon. So easy to wash.
I know it's all in fun, of course, but you do it so well. Thank you very much.
Oh, no, thank you. Bye. Cross my palm with silver, sir, and I shall reveal the secrets of the...
Pixie, well, what are you up to now?
Oh, Mr. Schumann, how wonderful! Here, come and let me read your palm.
Business a bit slack, Hunt?
Oh, it's been busy. It's just quieting down, but...
Good. You can go into the kitchen and help bring out the sandwiches and cakes for the catering stall. A few people waiting.
What now? What about me stall?
You're keen helping you, haven't you? It doesn't take two of you to sell this rubbish.
Yeah, well, she's gone to the dunny. Couldn't I wait till she gets
no.
back?
No. Don't make me repeat it, or you'll spend the rest of the day inside.
Hey, Phyllis, I'll look after your stall for you. I'm real good at selling stuff.
What about your own stall, Parker?
Oh, sold out, Miss Ferguson. Oh, all except for this one carrot. Charlie's going to take it home for Lucy, aren't you, Charlie?
Reckon I am.
There you are, Hunt. You've got no excuse. The kitchen.
Gallon.
Thought I'd just go and get a cup of tea.
Gee, don't go, Charlie. I'll be lonely if you go. Us poor Sheilas, we need a strong fella around. Just in case.
Just in case what?
Well, you know. Just in case.
And so all I want to do now is get a nice little flat somewhere that I can decorate. All pink, I think. Oh, and of course I'll need to get a job. And then I can lead a normal life just like ordinary people.
No more running away to get married?
Of course not. I know you find that's hard to believe, but, well, I don't need to do that sort of thing anymore. It was just a compulsion. Oh, well, I expect I will get married one day, but only once, and only if he's the right man.
That sounds very sensible to me.
Oh, goodness, I'm forgetting my job. Here, let me read your palm.
No. Let me foretell your future.
Mine?
I see a long and prosperous future as chief sales lady for Schumann's Bridal Boutique.
I can't believe it. Are you really meaning it? Oh, goodness.
You having a good time?
Oh, well, it's a great deal better than I expected from you people.
You go to many fates, do you?
Well, one does what one can. I was at the sheltered workshop last weekend. It's amazing how the handicapped cope.
You seem to manage okay.
What are you people going to do with the money you raise?
Well, we thought we'd get a new set of encyclopedia.
A new set?
Yeah, we've read the old ones. They're boring. See ya.
Thanks, love. I like a nice strong cuppa. Good. This one looks as if he could stand up and fight. Here, it is tea, isn't it?
Yeah, of course it is. Coffee's great. That's how I tell the difference.
What the hell are you doing away from the stall? Don't you have any brains?
I've got brains enough to do what Ferguson tells me. I didn't have any bloody choice. Now, look, if you want to blow the whole thing just to get even with Desmond, you go right ahead. But Dumbo's down there on the stall right now with the drunks.